If you're using AI to design UI by just typing prompts, this is why your designs look generic. The truth is, the tool isn't the problem, the input is. Most people ask AI design tools like Figma Make, Magic Path, Lovable to invent design. But great design doesn't start from nothing. It starts from inspiration and references. In this video, I will show you how to use simple UI screenshots to guide Figma Make, extract real design patterns, and turn them into a clean, scalable design system. By the end, you will know how to get premium-looking layouts instead of average AI output without copying and without guessing. Hi, my name is Sergey and welcome to my channel. I'm a creative director and here I talk about vibe coding, Figma and Framer. So don't forget to subscribe to learn more and like the video if you like it. And now let's get started. All right, so creating a mood board and getting inspiration from other designers and from other projects is like the first step in all of our projects. And it doesn't matter what I do, like I do visual identity or I do some web design. I go to Pinterest to get inspiration from it and to get some ideas of how I can and what I can do for a particular project. I create a mood board, show it to the client, and then we go on with the project. So for this tutorial, I want to show you how we can use this inspiration and to use other designs to create a design system for your project and to get actual design layout of the app, or doesn't matter what you do, using Figma Make. So currently I have my Pinterest open. This is my home screen, home feed. And what I want to do, I want to look for minimal green UI. So I previously looked at it already, searched for it. So I have some things here. For example, I like this image. I can download it. Then I go to something else. I can look at this one. I can also download it. And yeah, something like this maybe. Something like this. So I get these images to my computer. I can go to my Figma right now and I have some images saved, right? So I'll be using this image as a reference point for my design system and for my design layout of my future app that we'll be doing in building in this tutorial. So what I wanna do now, I wanna go to Figma Make and I press plus here and I select Figma Make. And here you can use this image and to send it to a Figma Make right here. So you select the image and you select send it to Figma Make. So basically you're sending this frame, or you can just drag and drop your image inside of this window. You can actually send even several of them if they're the same kind. And now I want to paste in a prompt that I have prepared. Let me just copy it and paste it over here and click run. So the prompt is deeply analyze the design of the attached screenshot to create a design system layout of every UI component needed in a design system for SaaS product service. Pay close attention to spacing, fonts, colors, design styles, and design principles. And what Figma Make is doing right now, it analyzes this image and creates a web app that will include all of these things separately. Like it will create a website for a design system. And this is super cool. This is amazing. This saves, I don't know, like 1 or 2, 3 days of work of a designer and developer. So this is super cool. You can actually do the same thing in a cursor, but today we're speaking only about Figma Make. So in Figma Make, you can actually switch to code mode and you can see that stuff is already being built. And you can see that Figma Make created an app It is building stuff. I can see that it has some already variables. You see lime, dark, light, but let's wait for the result. Also in Figma Make, you can publish your project to a domain if you want to, and you can also publish it to the community. And just share the link to someone else to see the project inside of the editor mode. Important thing to understand that this is available only on the paid plans, so be sure to check it out if you have a paid plan. For free plans, I think it's limited or it's not available. I'm not sure. I'm using a paid plan. So it may take some time, about like 5 to 10 minutes, because the prompt looks short, but actually it's a big one in terms of work. Figma Make also needs some time to implement all this stuff that we need. So I'll pause video for now and return to you when it's finished. All right, so welcome back. That is about to finish, and we can see the resume of the work, design system overview. And whoa, this is it. This is what it has created. And this looks really cool. Look at this. This looks like a website with color palette, color applications. You see, I like the colors. I like the styles. And it is a bit off because here you see it was more like pale, like pastel color, like a little bit desaturated. But here we can see that it is more saturated, but we can fix that, of course. But other than that, it looks pretty good. You can see the typography. We can see like display large, medium, all this stuff, font weights, even spacing, scales, components. You see buttons, they even work. Headers, metric cards. Wow, cards. You see, it looks really good. Well, something happened with the circle graphics here. It has icons. I believe this is from Phosphorus, probably. Toggles, they work. Look really nice. Drop downs, look at this. Wow, this is pretty cool. Design principles and design layouts here. Yeah, looks very nice. Very good. Very important thing is that, oh, actually it has, you see navigation. Very important is that it is in code. Everything is in code. So this is the React app, web app that can be used to create other pages or other apps, or you can publish it on the web for developers to use, so they can just like copy parts of it and use them in the real project. For you as a designer, what you can do with this, you can use this icon, copy design. So you copy design, you go back to your design file and you paste it here. And what do you get? You get the landing page with all the stuff that we just seen and that was created here. And the coolest thing is that we can select these elements and we can use them to create, for example, our variables. For example, look at this. This is enter 60. So what we can do, we can create font variables. So let's go to variables over here. We click, and now I can create a variable. I can create a number, and what I can do here, I can, for example, spacing, right? I can write SP, for example, 4, and then I can put the 4 here, and it's going to create me a variable. Then I can create a new one, for example, SP 8, and here I put the value 8, and so on. You get the idea. And then when I go back to this little thing, I can use variables and I can use spacing, space 4, for example, for sizes, or I can use this for spacing actually for like gaps or padding. It doesn't really matter. I can do the same thing for my text, for example. I can create a new number, and this is display large, and it's going to be 60. So I select 60, and it's going to be my font. For example, I can create a group, new group, and it's going to be my fonts or typography. Well, it doesn't really matter right now. In any case, I can create like fonts display large, then you can create a medium, and let's duplicate variable, and I'll select 48. And here, when I go back to my designs, now I can pick the variables and I can select that this one is 60 and this one is 48. So I go back to variables and let's change it to medium, right? So it's medium. So this way I can create a design system, you see, from the file that was created by Figma Make, and so on. Also the same thing for buttons. For example, I have three buttons here, like three states. I can select them, for example, like this, or four states, and I can create a component set. So I have a component set of buttons right now, and now I just need to change the name of the variants. For example, this one's gonna be lime, and this one's gonna be border, let's say, right? And this one is going to be ghost. And that's it. And now I just copy this button, throw it over here, and now, yep, I can see and play around with different variants of this button. It saves me, I don't know, like hours of time, because this everything is already here. I just need to like structure my file in terms of components and in terms of variables, and then I can use it to create other design layouts. But for this tutorial, what I'm going to do, I want to create an app or just a design layout of a home screen of the app, because we're lazy and we want AI to do everything. So I will copy another prompt that I have prepared, and I go back to my Figma Make file over here, and what I will do, I'll paste my prompt here, and I will tell it to create a new design, to create a new file here, right? Create a design of a home screen for to-do list app. Let's say iOS app, or just mobile. Let's say mobile app in the same style. And let's run the prompt. By the way, if you want to learn more about vibe coding, designing in Figma, or building websites on Framer, be sure to check out my courses and subscribe to my newsletter. The link will be in the description below. All right, so it's almost ready. We can see that it uses design elements, forest green, for primary colors with lime, all that stuff. The key feature progress card showing completion of the status, blah, 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 buttons. And we can see that it created a new page for this app. So it's like a separate. So this is very important. And let's see what we can get with it, or how it's going to look. I need to see if it's inside of the components. Here it is. Yeah, here's this page. Let's update it. I just want to add a link to this design because it's not in our main layout. So I'll ask it to add a button somewhere so I can go to this app actually. And it will add it over here probably. Let's see. Yep, here it is. Let's reload just in case. Reload the page. And one more thing that I would just wanted to show you, that this landing page with all the design system is also mobile friendly. You can see that it is really cool in terms of responsiveness. And let's see the app. So I go to the Todoist app, and this is how it looks. Wow, it looks pretty cool, right? Yeah, looks nice. You see, it has the calendar. Well, probably it doesn't work right now, but still, it looks like a real app. We can go back to the design system, but still. All right, so it shows the date. It shows the task in progress. I can add a new task here. Let's add something like hello. and I pressed enter and I added it. So it is an active task, so I can click and yeah, you see I've completed it. I can undo. For some reason this thing is not working properly, but it is okay. So I completed it, so I have four tasks remaining, so I can, you know, like click and finish everything. So it's basically, it is a working app that was created using the designs and using the design system from just an image that we got from Pinterest. And what we can do now, we can actually, again, copy this thing and go back to our design file and paste it here. And this is, here it is. So this is the app design, and we can work with it. Basically, we can use this as sort of like a wireframe for our future project, and we can use it to update it and to create a new design from it. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope now you understand how you can use simple AI screenshots to get real design systems using Figma Make and then use them to create your new unique, interesting and beautiful design layouts. So be sure to like the video if you like it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.